What is going on, ladies and gentlemen of YouTube, boys and girls of all ages, sinners and sinnerettes alike? I'm your faithful host, Darko Sinner, and I welcome you to Life is Strange 2. Now, I played the first one. I'm an absolute diehard fan of the first one. I wasn't that big of a fan of Before the Storm, but I played the hell out of it all the same. I bought the Digital Deluxe Edition, the whole hoopla. So, needless to say, when they said that they were going to make a second one, I was really, like, kind of blown away. I was like, I really personally didn't feel like they needed the second one. I felt like the first game had plenty of grounds to stand on, and it was just beautiful. It was just a masterpiece of a game, and one of the greatest Telltale games I've ever played. So, I was really excited about it, but this one, it's kind of different, but it still kind of follows into the same universe. Like earlier, it actually asked me, oh, did you choose to sacrifice Arcadia Bay? Well, if you played the first game, yes. No, I did not choose sacrifice Arcadia Bay. And for those of you who are wondering, no, I'm not technically spoiling anything, because for those of you who don't know anything about the first game, well, then you might not know. But anyway, spoiler alerts for the first game. And, yeah. So, without further ado, and just enough of my BS, would you like to enable subtitles? Of course I would love to enable subtitles. Let's just do this. Let's dive right in and see what all the hoopla is about the second game. I hope it's as good. I hope, really do hope so. So, I also was told that they're not going to do the same time travel mechanics as before, so I think we're going to have... Hello? Uh-oh. Okay.
Dispatch, I need to run a license check on that 10...
Officer Matthews, I've got a 1010 in progress. 1452 Lewis Avenue. I'm gonna need backup.
Copy that. All backup available.
He didn't do anything.
It's gonna be all right.
On the ground.
What the crap is going on? Like, just Thanos just show up and just wreck everyone? Just be all like, be gone, thoughts? So, yeah, I have no earthly idea what just happened there. So, I'm bamboozled. Now we're upbeat music and happiness, and there's a cute little raccoon, and it's Halloween. Happy Halloween, everybody. So I wonder what town we're in, since obviously we can't be in Arcadia Bay. So what's good? What are we going to be learning about? So who are you?
See you tonight! Don't be late, losers!
Late to what? What are we being late to? You have a spy.
Okay, update time. You heard back from Jen yet?
No. I'm sure she'll reply at some point.
Let me take a look at the situation. Hey, Jen, you going to the party tonight? Dude, we talked about this. Could you have any less game?
I'm no good at this.
Ooh, I know the feeling.
Yo, Jen, see you at the party. You let me know if I should bring handcuffs?
Oh my god, you thirsty bitch! Here, let Lila the Love Witch work her magic.
Okay, just don't make me sound like a loser.
I said matchmaker, not miracle worker.
Hey, hold on. Let me check it before you send.
Too late.
Too late.
Would be awesome to see you there. What? I could have texted that.
It's a good start. She'll text back, you'll see.
You know, I don't even know if I want to go tonight.
Oh, please.
Of course you do.
It's gonna be fun. You hate every party.
Oh, because they're all the same. Too many people, too fucking loud, everybody's wasted.
I know.
Yes, Sean.
Can't say
it. Just described a party.
Precisely.
Well, the suspense is killing me.
It's Dad. Wants to know if I'm coming home after school. Jeez, I'm not a 10-year-old.
He just cares about you, Sean.
Sean.
Anyway, you should be happy your dad's looking out for you.
Exactly.
Oh, it's Jen. Saying she can't wait to see us at the party!
What? Really? Yes!
Told you I would work my matchmaker magic.
Hell yeah.
So what should I wear tonight?
A condom.
Oh, haha.
Okay.
Pay plenty of attention in sex ed class, I see.
Hey, lovebirds. Back from the loony bin?
Shut the fuck up, dickhead. Damn, your neighbor's an asshole.
Exactly.
Yep. Always true to himself.
That was a real dick thing to say. Spooky. It is Spooktober.
Man, we need to find a couch for your yard one day.
Ooh, careful.
That's an oddly specific
thing. Last time my dad almost busted me out here.
Because you were alone? Your dad wouldn't bust me. He loves me.
Would he not?
So, you want a hit or not?
Refuse.
Nah. Maybe at the party.
No.
Track stars.
Not even then.
Smoke, you know?
Yeah, sure. I'll remember this when you're begging for a spliff tonight. Speaking of weed, I got that covered tonight. What else do we need? Eric says don't leave shit at the cabin, so we better make an official party list.
Hey, whoa, what the hell are
don't
you doing?
Don't move. You're my human post-it note.
No.
First,
no, I'm
we
not.
Need money for supplies, munchies, chips and dip, soda, etc.
This better wash off.
And of course, we must not forget the booze.
The booze.
I can probably snag a six-pack from Dad if he's got enough. Hey, did you ever think of maybe just sending a text instead?
Oh, right. Blankets. It's gonna get so chilly tonight. You and Jen are gonna need something to snuggle under. Oh, one last thing. C-O-N-D...
Oh, stop. You're out of room, punk.
You are out of room, punk. Good drawing.
Whoa, good drawing, Lila. Daniel's teacher would be proud of you.
Ha! The pretentious artist has spoken.
Exactly.
Don't fall asleep before me tonight, or you might see more of my skills.
You wish.
I feel bamboozled.
Planes, man. I want to hate them, but I'll miss them so much if I move somewhere else. Shit changes so fast. I get
exactly.
So emo sometimes, wondering what will happen to us once we graduate. Will you still be my BFF? Will shit ever get better than 1452 Lame Avenue?
Always be friends.
Yeah, man. Friends forever.
Yeah, but what happens if we go to different colleges? Or you get sick of me. Whatever.
You heard of the internet?
I have.
No way distance can tear us apart. We're freaking fighters.
Yeah, you're right. Best freaking fighters forever. Okay, it's getting way late and I gotta pick out my outfit for tonight. Skype me later when you're ready. Hugs. Talk to you soon.
Aww.
Hello, Friday night.
Exactly. Friday night. The ultimate gaming night. Well, this is when I would just, like, blow hundreds of hours on the most interesting
game. Hey, perfect timing. Just the son I wanted to see.
Uh-oh.
Oh, sure. But I'm a little busy.
Did you see Lila? She said we can go to the movies next week. She said...
Dude, bug her, not me. You're not exactly her type.
You're lucky she puts up with you.
Ugh, jeez. Thanks, Pop. I feel really supported right now.
You're welcome. And now we need an objective judge. That would be you.
Really?
Hey! No fair!
Court is in session. Judge Diaz, presiding over the case of the last Choco Crisp.
I have to go, get ready for a party and stuff. So...
Well, if you want to attend to a party and stuff, you have to earn it, Your Honor.
Oh, shit.
Hey, he swore.
Yes, I heard Tattletale. Please, Judge Diaz, be an example to the court and society. Then you can go hook up or chill or whatever. Now, who deserves to eat this final Choco Crisp? Your adorable little brother who eats about 10 bags a week, or your poor, suffering father who slaves over a hot engine to provide his family with a home and a garage?
Me. Come on, Judge.
Shh. Let him decide. Judge, the verdict, please.
All right, so...
Daniel is guilty of being a brat. So the Choco Crisp goes to... Senor Diaz.
What? No way.
Of course, bitch. Way. No.
Nope. I'm the law.
Your Honor, I can't let you punish an innocent man. So?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I always knew you'd confess.
Okay. Back to work. I hear an engine calling my name. And you better play nice together. Like you always do.
I have to go to work in my room, too.
Yeah? Don't hurry back.
Alright, so Sean...
Okay. Let's get this party list started.
Alright, so is there a way I can, like, check it right now? Holy crap, that's intricate. In case you help need with meth. Okay, that's interesting. Bottle of water. I guess this is like his backpack. We have $3.20. About average. Lighter. Skate tool. Headphones. Necessity. USB. Keys. Driver's license. Statistics. Pencil case. Test, he got a C+ on. Chronicles of the Basilisk, a fantasy book. And then a anti-bullying thing. And then got some of the texts here. So a lot of just different texts. So, his boss sounds like he's a pretty lazy kid. Doesn't like to do a whole lot, except for what benefits him. Typical kid, though. We got a couch there, so how do I check my list? Alright, that's cool. So you can use a little bit of refocus on the camera.
Daniel spends hundreds of hours yelling into the mic playing Minecraft with Noah.
Hey, what's wrong with Minecraft? There's the play box.
I don't know who plays more, Daniel or Dad. I could just stay home and binge Top Gear with Dad and Daniel, but not tonight. What if Jen came over? We can build a fire and... Dude, stop.
Don't sell yourself short, dude. You never know. The night is still young, as they say. Angry note? What?
That's right. Qué pendejo.
Between our two properties. Okay. Wonder if that is from the Captain Spirit game. I wonder if that's Captain Spirit's dad.
Real funny, Dad.
Drug money. No, don't steal coins.
That's not nice. Dad tries so hard to get on a healthy diet. I can't wait for him to be on Instagram. Meet the Diaz. Organization experts.
I've seen worse.
What the? Is Dad baking something?
Corn syrup? Maybe it's part of this pasta recipe.
Dad's secret recipe fucking rules, actually.
I bet it does. No, it doesn't. You're all potty mouth.
Daniel kept saying, I'm freezing. But we couldn't get him off the skis.
Cool. That's some homework right here.
At least I don't have to help Daniel out with math. Thanks, Dad.
Guess their dad is pretty good at the math. Oh, just for right now, guys, I'm just trying to, like, investigate the different areas.
I need to take care of that party list.
Yeah. No. I'm trying to figure out how to, like, access that list, though. So, backpack. Hunt for munchies, find drinks for Eric Sparter. Ask Dad for some money and find a blanket. Okay. So, drinks should be in a fridge. Soda. Take the soda.
This will work. I don't want to get wasted in front of Jen.
Yes. Do not take beer, especially if you're underage. Don't be that guy.
Man.
Lean party.
Jen could live off this crap.
But that is the way. Set a good example for the good Samaritan.
Cross that off the list. Drinks down. Food to go.
Okay, so we gotta hunt down munchies. Which I am quite proficient in the art of munchie gathering. Me? Oh, don't bet a cookies? Oh my god. Halloween candy? What are chips? The decisions are overwhelming. Did you only get Halloween candy? Well, Halloween candy is actually way better, like, afterward. And chips are meh. Cookies, though. I'm feeling the cookies.
You're coming with me.
Can we take them all? No, you can only take one. Well, that's lame. That's bloody lame. Alright, now a blanket, and then I think the last thing we can do is... Seriously though, he's not actually going with right. Oh my god, that's weird. That is a little disturbed.
Lila's so hyped up for tonight. Better hurry.
Alright, so if I was a blanket, where would I be? Well, I haven't really checked much of else of the house yet, so wait, there's a laundry room. Aha! Wait, no, this is the bathroom. You silly freaking...
Well, it's not my turn to do the laundry.
Uh-oh. Somebody slacking. Somebody be slacking on their job. Better not do that. No, we ain't gonna do no practicing. We're just gonna go in there. Just be all like, hey, yo, my dear. You shall love me. For I am... the dark. Wait. Haven't checked this room yet. Aha! Found it. Name tag?
Very funny, Lila.
What did that say?
Good thing my boss has a sense of humor. Kind of.
Babe's assistant. Sure. No.
Asshole.
Hey, you might need that.
My first hangover. Dad laughed at me so Eric got us some purple last month. It was fucking insane. Lila provides the weed tonight. I better be ready.
Alrighty, so we have that. We're good there. What's on the laptop?
Sorry, Lila. I'm just not a selfies kind of guy. Okay. Don't be a stalker, Sean. Man, this is taking forever. Do they want me to pay for it?
What is this? Oh.
Oh my god. The internet was a mistake.
Eh, depends on your point of view. I personally feel like it was not.
Damn. I still have like 10 books left in the series. I won't finish until I'm 20.
Well, at least you have something going for you. Chronicles of the Basculus. Trying to do some...
Oh, hi Gunther. Sorry. You stay hidden here. Dad wants me to keep this junk as backup. Right. Not sure Daniel is ready to be an uncle yet.
Nope.
We got these for free during sex ed last year.
Well, that's good. Schools should implement stuff like that. At least I feel like it. I never got that. I just got really cool lectures about, like, all the sex ed stuff. So, meh. Ooh!
Time to get in the mood for tonight.
So.
How many times have I watched it? Not enough.
Nope. Whatever this is, it needs to not. No, we're good. I'm good. Alright, so.
Thanks, Daniel. I'll, treasure this gift always.
So the stands are matches, it looks like.
I'll, treasure this gift always. I really like that one. I don't totally suck.
So, you can sit down and draw whatever, but I still need a blanket.
I think I know what to ask for Christmas.
I mean, I guess, if you're into that type of thing. But we obviously can't take the one from his bed.
I'll never make varsity at this rate.
Just keep pushing. You could do it. I believe.
Man, I so don't want to work this weekend.
But you have to, and it's part of your responsibilities as a young adult. We shall not.
Dude, come on, open up.
Why?
Because.
Okay.
Because? And then the kid just gives in?
What are you doing in there, Dr. Frankenstein?
You gave my choco crisp to Dad.
So what? He gave it back. Dude, you're so spoiled. What's with the scissors?
You'll see, but not now. So don't come in.
Okay, then.
Okay, fine. Don't tell me. After all, I'm only your big brother, who looks after you and takes care of you.
Stop it. All I can say is, watch out for my costume in 3 days. This Halloween is gonna be awesome. Are you going to the party tonight at Aerith's house? Will Lila be there?
Yes, and no. You can't go. Teenagers only.
I bet Lila would let me go. She's way nicer to me than you. Did she ask about me?
Cheating on you, wants to marry you.
Yes, she wants to marry you.
Shut up! Aunt, I don't even care if I can't go. Because I have secret stuff to do. Alone.
Of course you do.
I can see that.
Daniel's always up to something. Wonder what's next.
Interesting. So far, it's starting to play just like,
I'm broke, so I better find some cash for tonight.
Sorry, it's starting to act like a lot like the Captain Spirits, but I'm pretty sure there's going to be a lot more to, like, try to engage into. I seriously feel like there's a blanket somewhere I can grab here, but obviously not. Alright, that was a really unneeded cutaway. So, I guess check down here.
Alright, Dad. Where do you put the blankets?
Oh. Women's bike. Ski stuff. Oh, there we are. Blankets.
Thank God I don't have to take one of Daniel's.
Indeed.
I'm sure Dad won't miss one blanket for the night.
You don't know that. For all you know, he could totally... That could be like the blanket that saves his life.
Can't believe Dad actually asked me to tag up this wall. Well, of course, he asked Daniel too.
That you, Sean?
Yeah.
Yeah. Don't get too excited, kid. You're making me nervous. Hey. Since you're creeping around up there, can you pass me the wrench in the top red drawer over there?
Sure, can do.
Top red drawer.
There's no wrench here.
Ah, shoot, must be somewhere else then. Take a look around. I know I left it nearby. It's a 16mm reversible flex wrench.
Jeez. That was definitely my plan for tonight. So, yeah. Hold on.
Sam came by the garage today. Told me to tell you hi for him.
How's his leg?
Well, you know, old fossils like us don't heal the way you do.
Remind me never to get old.
Hey, it beats the alternative.
They look spent to hell. True. You could never heal. And be broken forever.
Hey, I got it. I think.
Wrong size. I need a 16 millimeter. Hey, did you get your English midterm back?
Yeah. I got a B.
A B? But you were so confident about the essay you wrote.
Yeah, I think Mrs. Calloway is just prejudiced against Vonnegut.
But Slaughterhouse-Five is amazing.
Hey, you don't gotta tell me. Tell her.
Next parent-teacher meeting? She's getting a piece of my mind.
Uh-oh.
Here you go.
Nah. I need one with the black switch on it, so I can change its direction.
Okay, so that's not... So you need a 16 millimeter, but the one with a black switch. So I can change its direction. That's an 18 millimeter, so that ain't gonna help me out much. That's not gonna help me much either.
Hey, seriously. What's taking you so long?
Hey, seriously, I'm not a mechanic.
Come on, bring me anything, really. I'll tell you if it's the right one.
Hello.
Hey, I got it. I think.
Should have a flex head. I can't reach that bolt otherwise. Okay, hey, forget it. I'll do it with this one right here. It'll probably work.
So, I don't know.
Shit! All right, never mind, enough of this. I'm done. Hey, quick tip, my son. Go Google wrenches and see what you can learn.
Yeah, sure.
I know it's not your thing, but you gotta learn a trade. Art, athletics, engineering, I don't care. As long as you put your heart into it.
I'm trying. I just don't know what direction to go.
You're only 16 years old. You've got time to figure it out. Trust me, took me a while, too.
And you happy with it? I mean, your job, living here?
Of course I am. We're doing great. Maybe one day when I retire, I'll go back to Mexico, to Puerto Lobos. But until then...
Ugh, I've heard this one before.
I don't even know why I'm fixing you a sweet car for graduation.
Ugh, come on. It's wicked. I'm just not used to driving.
You better get used to it, or you'll be taking your date to prom on the number 30 bus.
Like I'm going on tons of dates. Not when Daniel's cock-blocking me the whole time.
He's 9. He doesn't even know what cock-blocking is. He looks up to you, Jean. Try and help him. It's what family is for.
Exactly.
Things are kind of scary out there in this country right now.
Hell yeah. Yeah.
Oh, by the way...
Ha! I was wondering how long it'd take. You need money for the party tonight, right? Shh. Just be honest with me. No bullshit. Are you using this money to buy alcohol? Weed?
Honestly, it's the best
part. I mean...
Be straight.
Yeah, probably. But we'll be partying at a house and nobody's driving home. I swear.
Well, everybody's gotta get home somehow. But yeah, you and Lila better not get in any car with somebody who can't walk straight.
Holy shit, 40 bucks? Really?
Yeah, why not? You did a good job on the lawn. Plus, I appreciate that you didn't lie to me.
Thanks, Dad.
Honesty's best policy, kids.
Just be careful.
Learn.
That's all I'm asking for, okay? I know what kind of crazy shit kids can get into.
When you were my age, did you party a lot?
Sorry. What happens in Mexico
stays in Mexico.
Get out of here before I change my mind about that cash. And keep an eye on Daniel while you're home. Would you?
All right. Thanks, Dad.
Hey, hey, hey. Not so fast, Shawnee boy. Don't you think your papito deserves a hug?
Hell yeah, he does.
Okay, have fun. But not too much.
I won't. Promise. Bye. Love ya.
I love you too, hijo.
I bet Dad had a pretty wild teenagehood. Even though he won't tell. I would be fucked if I had to help Dad in the shop.
That is a lot.
It'll be weird having my own car. But then I could take Jen out. If she wants.
You'll love it. It's going to be the best thing ever. Alright, so. I'll take a wild guess. Just want to take a wild guess. It was this one, wasn't it? I'm fairly certain it was that one. So, if I had the ability to reverse time like Max did, then I would be able to do it. I like how, like, if you messed up like three times, something like that, like everything would change up. So, it works out. That's good. I'm digging this so far. Liking it. I think that's everything, kids. Pack a bag for the night. Alright. Head in your room, pack a bag. You ready to go? Alright. And there's a bean bag. Sit around for and draw for a bit while I try to assess what to do. Actually, no, we need to find a bag. We need to find a bag. Where would a bag be if I was... Hey, there's a bag. Pack it. What is this? The journal's way. He has real major talent in art. So, that's a thing. Alright, so 4320. See, you didn't have to take any money or anything. Straight up, you were honest, and look, you got way more than 10. Aha! Nailed it. Gotta find a bag.
Damn. The guy never stops working.
It's a lot, though. Is that him or what he has to pay? That's a, like, wait. Like, what were all those parts?
Damn. The guy never stops working.
Services? Like, what the hell? Oh, he rebuilt an entire engine. Okay, then that makes more sense.
Okay, gotta go back to the living room and load the backpack.
Okay. Why didn't you just say so? So far, it's kind of a slower start than the first game.
Finally, ready to go.
First game really got you.
My laptop.
First game really got you like headlong into the action, but this one's kind of like a slow. So you kind of get to get introduced to every little character in more slower fashion. Not a complaint, but just an observation. I just would have to say. Everything looks in tip-top shape. And I like how all the objectives are kind of like here, but I'm pretty sure you can find different things. I think what we'll do is we'll go to the point right before we hit the party, and then I think we'll kill it here, and then we'll go from there. So we'll go Skype what's-her-face, and we will go from there, kiddies. Excitement through the roof.
Sorry, Lila. I'm just not a selfies kind of guy.
Oh, lower boy. Just give me a minute. Gee, where did I put the... hold on. Okay, hi. Did you get everything on your hand list?
It's all in my backpack, yeah. Dad hooked me up with some cash, so we're set for the night. In case we need anything else.
Or if you and Jen need anything else.
Uh-oh.
Okay, serious talk. What are you gonna say to Jen tonight?
I don't know. Whatever. Do I need to practice?
I've seen you in action. Yes. You're totally into her, right?
Duh. Why do you think I'm freaking out? She's so super cool.
You're super cute. Just be yourself. That's why she's into you.
Sean, I'm done. Look. I made zombie blood. It's, corn syrup and food coloring. Hey. Hi, Lila.
Get out of my room, Daniel.
I was just...
Come on, man.
Just
bugging the shit out of me again after I told you to knock? Yeah,
but...
I know. Anyway.
Sean, you're an asshole. What's your problem?
But...
I want to see zombie blood if you don't.
You're right.
Sorry. I'll make it up to him. He knows I can be a dick. I'm just stressed out about tonight.
Oh, please. We're gonna have so much fun. Maybe tonight's the night.
Don't jinx me.
Jinx? I'm your lucky charm, bitch.
Okay. So when are you coming over?
I just have to hit up the momster for the car keys and hope she doesn't make me lie too much about the party. I'm already in trouble from last time.
This time, don't get caught.
Let me see that drawing.
This might be my masterpiece.
Well, yeah. It's my portrait.
Interesting.
Oh, shit. Jen just posted her outfit for tonight.
What?
On her wall. You should check it up. It might... get your attention.
Whoa. Her hair.
Whoa, indeed. I told you she was super into you, man.
What's her profile picture got to do with me?
Huh. You will see.
It's for Halloween.
I see you, Sean. Should we set the wedding date now?
Hey, come on. It's just a heart. I like her hair, okay? No big deal.
Sure.
Can you get up? Because your brother's in trouble right now, and I need to...
Why is Derek Anderson all over Jen's profile?
Leave me alone! I'll call my dad!
Hold on, okay? Something's going on outside.
What do you mean? Hey!
Look at my shirt, asshole!
What's the big deal? It's Halloween!
Hey, don't ever touch my brother! You hear me, Brett? Fuck you, Diaz. He got his fake blood shit all over my shirt. Look!
I told you, it was an accident. You better leave us alone.
Oh yeah, go hide in your dad's garage. Pussies. You think you own the block?
Okay, so obviously he's just being a real big asshole. But... let's confront him.
Dude, step back. He didn't mean it. He's a fucking kid. He's a fucking retard.
What did you just say?
You heard me, bitch.
Don't ever touch him again.
Or what? You gonna get your daddy?
Hey, asshole. I don't need him to protect me from you.
Oh, you wanna go?
Oh yeah, motherfucker?
Then go back to your own country.
Whoa! Sean, you hit him!
Get inside, now!
Sean!
You're dead meat, bitch! You and your whole
damn,
fucking kid family
can fight.
Are going to jail! Losers!
What's going on?
Me! Daniel, get over here!
Sean, is he hurt?
Okay, step away! Now!
Calm down, officer!
Shut up! And step back!
Oh, shit.
On the ground! Now!
The blood is fake, though.
This guy was beating up my little brother!
Now! Hands behind your head!
Sean!
This is fucking bullshit!
Ooh, what is up with the frame
now?
Sean, what's happening?
Get on the ground,
sir! Dad! We didn't do anything!
Sean, be quiet!
I swear!
Officer,
I'm sorry, Dad!
Daddy!
Be quiet!
I wanna go home!
They're good kids, officer.
Don't move.
I'm sure they didn't do anything!
I said don't move!
Stop this.
We didn't do anything!
It's gonna be alright!
On the ground!
Wow, I made a terrible decision then. What the fuck? Well, that was the thing, kids. We're not done. Oh. Alright, so this is 2 days after the accident.
No, man. We can't stop here. We gotta keep going. No pouting, okay? Come on.
But my feet really hurt. These shoes suck. And we've been walking for 4 days.
What? Only two. Don't even try that shit.
And my back hurts from sleeping under that stupid bridge.
Yeah, so does mine. I was there too. Just knock it off. I hate it when you act like this. This is how people camp in the woods. It's not like being at home or in your room. This is a real adventure, right? So, come on, let's hit the trail. Seriously.
Those are some nice shoes,
though.
Where's
Dad?
Daniel, come on. We gotta go.
Why isn't Dad with us, Sean?
You gotta be up front.
Doesn't he want to go camping too?
Yes, but I told you that He can't. I told you. Okay?
Okay. But I'm so sick of walking. I just wish I was back in my room.
I know. Hey, at least we don't have to go to school on Monday, right?
Yeah.
Look, everybody's gonna be so stoked when they find out how far you walked.
Really? Really? I bet Dad would be too. Do you think we walked, like, maybe 100 miles?
Probably 200. Feels like it.
Ooh, awesome possum. But next time, Dad better get me a good pair of shoes, like yours.
Dude, Bigfoot doesn't need good shoes.
I'd rather be a wolf. Ow! We could be wolves.
Yeah, that works.
That's probably their spirit just animal.
Work on that howl. Hey, you know what? Let's see if you can walk the whole way without complaining once, huh?
Like, you don't whine too?
I don't whine. I tag your ass and run. You're it.
No way. Not fair.
Whatever.
Okay. I'm a zombie, and I'm gonna eat you. Blah!
That's awesome. Their relationship seems hella believable, too. Oh, you dropped your mask, dude. That was really cool. Life Strange 2, Episode 1, Roads. So yeah, like, that hit off pretty quick. Scratch what I said earlier about it having a slow start, because that shit hit the fan really quick. But I think eventually him not telling him about his dad being dead is going to bite him in the ass later. So that's definitely a decision that doesn't need to be made. I wonder what happens if you would have confronted your brother. Would the events still happen the same way, or how would we look at it? But definitely watching these two grow and everything is going to be interesting. Hopefully there are some tie-ins to the first two games, and even the awesome The Adventures of Captain Spirit. So, I look forward to it. But anyways, as soon as this kicks in, I think we'll cut the video here, or unless the episode is done, which I can also believe. I can also 100% believe.
Stop! You know what? You're not allowed to say that. Ever again.
Yes, sir.
You'll be the first one to know when we get there, okay? I'm tired and hungry too. Listen, this looks like a perfect place to camp out. I bet we're not the first people to stay the night.
Alright, so I'll kill it there. So, we're gonna end it. Go ahead and end the gameplay right there. We'll be able to pick up in the next episode to progress on to the further ones. So far, I'm enjoying it. Nothing really to like spite off. It just feels like the natural same process, the same gameplay. Your decisions matter. Every little thing that you do matters. I just hope they continue that and make improvements on that from the last game. So, but yeah, like and subscribe, hit the little bell icon to be notified of all events and goings-on that are going on with Darko Center. You'll be seeing two different gameplays hopefully going up here in the next few days. And as always, I am your faithful companion, Darko Sinner, and I'll see you guys later.